في أعمال of the kafir, that the actions of the disbeliever, that they are mahbuta, that they are null and يعني nullified. Even if those a'mal be from the salihat fi zahiriha, يعني even if they be يعني from what's apparent, from the good deeds, or we can say even if they be from the a'mal that Islam encourages. And this is a very important point to make here, ya ikhwan. This is a very important point to make. Why? Because يعني, often we hear this shubha, this doubt, or this confusion. And we hear this doubt or this confusion from some of the people. يعني, that a person's affair, يعني, it can't be that bad. The hal of the kafir, يعني, it can't be that bad. Because, you know, he did so much good. نعم, to the extent, ya ikhwan, that some of them, that when a kafir passes away, for example, يعني, say for example, someone who was famous, that they say, يعني, he has done so much good. You know, he's done so much good. Inshallah ta'ala, he will go to Jannah. You know, inshallah, Allah will forgive him. And this, ya ikhwan, no doubt, is from the kate of the shaytan, from the plots of the shaytan. Why? Because, يعني, that they are, in some regards, taking lightly the affair of kufr, wal-iyadu billah, and dying upon kufr. They have now taken that affair lightly, or, يعني, cast it aside, and look towards, يعني, the fact that, oh, but he was, يعني, a good individual, or, يعني, he performed some good deeds, and he done some acts that Islam encourages with. You know, so this, in reality, is taking the affair of kufr lightly. وَلَعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. But in reality, that we say that in reality, that even though, يعني, he may benefit from good things that he has done here in this dunya. طيب, so he may benefit from good things that he has done here in this dunya. But in the akhirah, in the hereafter, then he has no benefit from them. طيب, so the disbeliever, he may benefit from some of the good things that he has done here in this dunya. And whilst he is alive. But in the hereafter, then he has no benefit from those good things that he has done. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said in Surah Hud, مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتَهَا نُوَفِّي إِلَيْهِمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فِيهَا وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يُبْخَسُونَ. That whosoever desires the life of this world and its zina, is adornment, نوفي إليهم أعمالهم فيها, that we shall repay them for their good deeds therein. وهم فيها لا يبخسون. And يعني, they will not be deprived therein. But then he said, سبحانه وتعالى, أولئك الذين ليس لهم في الآخرة إلا النار. That they are those for whom there is nothing in the hereafter except the fire. وَحَبِطَ مَا صَنَعُوا فِيهَا وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And lost is what they did therein, يعني, in the dunya. And worthless is that which they used to do. So, يعني, a clear proof that in the hereafter, that their actions are null and void. And that's why, أيها الإخوة, likewise we find when Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها, when she asked The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as occurs in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, that when she asked him alayhi salatu wa salam about Ibn Jud'an, and Ibn Jud'an was a kafir, was a disbeliever, who used to be known to feed the poor. He was known to feed the poor. That when she asked him alayhi salatu wasalam, and she said, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ Ibn Jud'an كَانَ فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَصِلُ الرَّحِمِ وَيُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينِ فَهَلْ ذَلِكَ نَافِعُهُ. That she said, O Messenger of Allah, Ibn Jud'an, that in the days of pre-Islamic ignorance, that he used to maintain the ties of kinship, and he used to feed the poor. فَهَلْ ذَاكَ نَافِعُهُ. And will that have any benefit for him? Would it benefit him? So he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, as is mentioned in the hadith, لَا يَنْفَعُهُ. لَا يَنْفَعُهُ. It will not benefit him. Then he said, إِنَّهُ لَمْ يَقُلْ يَوْمًا رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي خَطِيئَةِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. For he did not say for a single day, O my Lord, forgive me for my sins on the day of recompense. They will not benefit him. His actions will not benefit him. For he did not say a single day, O my Lord, forgive me for my sins or my mistakes, my shortcomings on the day of recompense. فَالشَّاهِدْ بَرَكَ اللَّهُ فِيكُمْ. So the point here is that the actions of the disbeliever, that they are not accepted. Regardless of that which he performed, by way of good, lofty actions that Islam encourages, but his actions in the hereafter, that they are of no avail to him. They will not benefit him in the slightest.